Hi, Photo 2 students. This is a little video just to describe your weekly word assignment that we'll be going through in this class. Your first go-to spot is to click on the weekly word folder here. Within here, I'm going to have this video posted at the top along with the instructions, which you'll find right in here. These instructions just give you an idea of the timeline on things, definitions of words, and what you're supposed to be trying to accomplish with this, as long as how you're graded. As well as how you're graded on there. So each week we're going to be having a word that you're going to take a picture that will represent that word in the way that you think it means. I want you to try to get creative with this and not just stick with the first idea that comes to mind, but push yourself to that second or third idea. Try to show that you're really understanding how to create an interesting picture with whatever device you're using to take the picture. When you are done with a photo, which you can certainly complete the photos ahead of the due date and just submit them, I would like you to describe how you're showing your word within the photograph. So when you're uploading the picture, you're going to see a little comments box that'll be right underneath the upload section for the file. I'd like you to type right in there to explain how your idea is seen. So how is that photograph really showing the word? This is the only area that you're going to be writing what you think your photo means. When we get to our discussion post, all you're going to be doing is uploading just the picture. So we'll let other people look at the photo and see what they thought you meant. So that's going to be part of the discussion for it. So again, you'll upload your actual picture, which will be with summative credit right here, within each of the spots for the weekly words. And you'll see them listed all the way down here up until the last one, which is weekly word 8. And again, it's just one photo. After you're done with uploading your picture there, you're going to be submitting the photo again, really more just posting it within the discussion for that photo. So you'll click on the discussion. Then you'll see a spot where you can write a comment. You won't actually be writing a comment, you'll simply be inserting a picture or attaching a photo. I think right here, if you click on the file attachment, that's going to be the way that you can do it. Otherwise, you can insert content right here. Looks like your best bet is down here in the file section. So you might go to a photo that you have within a folder and insert it that way. You don't even need to leave a comment. It's just going to be your photo. We're going to let others talk about your photo. So that'll get to be what I'll explain next here. So the first direction here is to make sure that you've uploaded your photo. Then you're going to be looking at three other students' photographs. I want you to describe what you're seeing in the picture. How do you think that they're trying to show the word with the photo that they took? Right? Then I want you to talk about what you liked in the photo. So what are some things that you thought they did well, either with how creative they were getting with their idea, how well they used their device to capture a picture of high quality and good composition, things like that. And then what are some things that you think could be improved in the picture? So when you're looking at it, if there are any distractions in the photo, describe what they are. You can critique each other in this way and learn from each other to help improve your work. That's what the big goal of this is. So your grade for this one is in the formative category for your discussions, summative for the actual picture that you submit in the other area. You get 5 points for just adding your photo in, and then 5 points for each of the different posts that you put on other students' pictures. Great. Try to think about this, like using full sentences, fully explaining yourself, being school appropriate in the way that we talk to each other. And I reserve the right to remove any posts. We don't want to ever bully anything like that through this online discussion board that we're going to be having. Choose your words wisely. That's just an important thing. You can't always tell what people meant in the way that they're writing if they aren't fully explaining themselves. All right. I think that's enough to kind of get you going on this. Again, you can do your pictures ahead of time. You don't need to wait until the day that it's due to take the picture. You can simply do them all ahead of time, get them in the right spot, and then just be ready to do the discussion on the day that we're going to do the discussion according to our calendar for the class.